Hello everyone, my name is Bethany Chapman. I am a sports dietitian and certified mind-body eating coach. Today I am here chatting a little bit about the hunger and fullness scale. I find this is really important and a pretty simple concept that can have profound impact. And really, this is the experiment of intuitive eating and getting back to recognizing body signals of hunger and fullness to support a healthier relationship with food and body. So imagine there being a scale, but instead of measuring our weight in pounds or kilograms, we are using it to gauge our hunger and gauge and recognize when we're feeling full. So this is a really simple concept, but like I said, it has a huge, profound impact. And it really starts with just tuning back into that body wisdom a little bit more and tuning into our body. So what it looks like is there's a continuum from 0 to 10 in terms of hunger and fullness, 0 or 1 being painfully hungry, super ravenous. I always like to call this hangry, and my family would admit that I do experience hanger at times and it's not a good situation. So really important that we don't end up on that hanger, really irritable, anxious. Those types of emotions happen when we're on that 0 to 1, even 2 on that hunger and fullness scale. We might be feeling famished, lightheaded. Our stomach is definitely growling at that point. And then at the opposite end of that hunger and fullness is that full, uncomfortably full. That's where we're feeling like we're at a 10. We've overeaten to the point where we're feeling pretty uncomfortable. We're feeling stuffed, maybe even a little nauseous. I always like to think of Thanksgiving. It's like we eat all that food and it's almost like we feel exhausted and tired and just uncomfortably full. We just don't want to do anything after that. So I like to talk to clients about eating to the point of feeling energized rather than eating to the point where we're feeling uncomfortable and feeling kind of sluggish and not super energized. So the magic really lies in those middle numbers, anywhere from 3 to 7. And this is where we want to stay most of the time, where we're eating till we're feeling moderately full, comfortably satisfied, and we're starting to initiate eating before we're getting to that hanger point. We're feeling just a little slight bit of hunger. So this can be a really, really helpful guide in reconnecting with that body wisdom. And really, in our society, we're so bombarded with fad diets, external food rules, that we've just lost touch with those internal cues. But if we can use this as a guide to, rather than look at the clock and use that as a guide of when we should be eating or having more mindless snacks. Maybe we're not even feeling hungry, but we're reaching for a snack just out of rhythm and routine, right? We reach for the cupboard or we reach for the fridge because we're in the kitchen. So if we can stop and take a minute before we're eating, while we're eating, and after we've finished eating, and really assess, where am I on this hunger and fullness scale? And it sounds simple, but it's actually pretty complicated. It doesn't happen just naturally, because really when it comes to the things that we're doing automatically and on autopilot, there's a pretty high percentage of our day that is just set to autopilot. And so to stop and actually take a minute and tune into that body wisdom can take time and practice. So I want you to know it's not going to happen overnight, but slowly tuning in. And one way that can be really helpful when we're creating habits is habit stacking. So when I sit down at the table to eat my lunch, I'm going to tune in and I'm going to ask myself, where am I falling on this hunger and fullness scale? After I've spent maybe 10 minutes eating or 5 minutes eating, I'm going to tune back in and see, where am I falling on this hunger and fullness scale? And maybe even after we've finished our plate or we've come to a pause when we're eating, consistently kind of coming back to that and recognizing, a lot of us use a clean plate as an indicator that we're feeling satisfied or that our meal is done, rather than really recognizing where we're falling on that hunger and fullness scale. So this is really what it means to become more of an intuitive eater, is relearning and trusting ourselves. It means honoring that hunger without judgment, and also respecting our fullness without guilt. Sometimes we are going to end up on these extremes. I still do. Everyone will. We're human, right? There's going to be moments where we eat beyond that feeling of fullness and we're uncomfortable. There's going to be moments where the day slips by and all of a sudden it's 3-4 o'clock. We haven't eaten lunch and we're hangry, right? So just honoring that, recognizing and knowing, and reflecting what happened, what might have caused this, and how we might adjust and adapt moving forward, but not being harsh and feeling guilty and those negative emotions, because it creates that negative habit loop when we have those negative thoughts and feelings. So again, practicing intuitive eating isn't always easy. It really does require a lot of mindfulness, patience, and self-compassion, but it's really letting go of that diet mentality and embracing food freedom, letting our body let us know where we're at in terms of hunger and fullness. And if we're eating in a moment where we're not actually feeling that hunger, what else might be going on? What else might we be hungering for in that moment to kind of help guide us moving forward of what other ways we might be using food, because food is used in many different ways. So intuitive eating isn't about perfection. It's about progress. It's a journey of self-discovery and self-care, and it's about finding balance, pleasure, and joy in eating once again. So on that note, I invite you to start or continue practicing paying attention to your hunger and fullness cues. I'm going to share this hunger and fullness scale as a resource, and I would love to hear from you. What are your biggest challenges, do you feel, in terms of tuning into that hunger and fullness and those intuitive cues? All right. I hope you have a wonderful day, and we'll connect again soon.